This video will explain how to read these diagrams that show feedback loops. Each feedback loop has a few different features. The ovals describe steps in a process in the world that either happened long ago or is happening today. A timeline, not shown here, places each feedback loop in a historical context. Arrows show cause and effect relationships. Sometimes the change in the first oval causes the next step to increase or become more common. This is represented with a red arrow and a plus sign. Other times, the changes in the first oval causes the next step to decrease or become less common. This is represented by a blue arrow with a negative sign. We will start by examining a positive feedback loop from Earth's past in which grasslands spread due to large herbivores. Over 40 million years ago, large herbivores evolved. A population of large herbivores, like buffalo, can relatively quickly eliminate large plants in an area as they eat and trample them. When large plants are eliminated, grasses can quickly and easily grow to take their place. Grasses are relatively easy for many herbivores to digest and grow back quickly when an area is cleared. This provides more food for herbivores. Herbivores that can eat grass therefore increase in number. The increased herbivore population has two effects. First, they have to move to new areas to find new food sources. Second, they produce a lot of waste. We will come back to the new areas and focus on the waste for a minute. Herbivore waste is a good fertilizer and improves the soil over time, which causes grasses to grow more quickly and in more places, allowing for a greater herbivore population. As the herbivore population grew, the large herbivores moved to new areas, clearing them of large plants and spreading grasslands. This negative feedback loop will look a little different. It is happening today, but it also involves the clouds that form due to climate change, somewhat slowing the effects of climate change. As you have figured out, global temperatures are increasing due to increased carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. When temperatures increase, more water will evaporate. On average, more clouds form around the world as more water evaporates. Clouds have a higher albedo than most of Earth's surface, so the planet's average albedo increases. We figured out last lesson that higher albedo means less light will reach Earth's surface. If less light reaches Earth's surfaces, that will cause a decreasing trend in average global temperatures as there is less energy in the Earth system. But lower temperatures mean that less water will evaporate. If less water is evaporating, there will be fewer clouds, which means Earth's average albedo will actually decrease. And if average albedo decreases, more light will reach Earth's surface, which will cause global temperatures to increase on average, causing this cycle to repeat. In this way, clouds work to slow down climate change with a negative feedback loop that somewhat slows changes in global temperatures, even as other factors like carbon dioxide push them higher.